driverless horses going through the field, so we've got all sorts of issues here. Going really fast now. Goes into overdrive now, and he pulled away. Causes an upset. What's he got left? Ideal Scott.
But let's start with the lucky bridesmaids first for a change. In the Breeders' Crown three-year-old trot final, the Blitz bombed. Breathalyzed and put aside for quite the crowning moment in a consistent Kiwi Filly's career.
Blitz Them Call to lead 3 metres to Quite a Moment. Who's going to test the favourite? It's Blitz Them Call to Quite a Moment going to him. Quite a Moment hit the lead. Quite a Moment got a neck in front. And Quite a Moment causes an upset. Quite a Moment wins Greg Sugars.
And there's icing on the career cake of Carpenter's Daughter, flogging the thunder off everyone's favourite four-year-old pacing lady on the day.
Cheer the ladies under pressure. Born Again Sassy, Carpenter's Daughter run on. It's Lighting Every Day in front. Carpenter's Daughter, Born Again Sassy. Lighting Every Day in front from Carpenter's Daughter. Lighting Every Day, Carpenter's Daughter grabbing it and got up. Carpenter's Daughter's won it.
Let's bling on the real stars. Team McCarthy Australia sorted the lucrative two-year-old boys pacing final very early in the piece.
And Let Us Rock Them went clear. All Eyes on Us went up into second spot, and third is Bling It On. So the stablemates are 1, 2, 3 hitting off the back. Let Us Rock Them in front. Bling It On gets out. Our Sky Major next into the straight. It's Let Us Rock Them. Bling It On moving up to it. Bling It On goes up to Let Us Rock Them. It's Bling It On taking the lead now. The favourite draws clear from Let Us Rock Them, and Bling It On goes on to score. Bling It On first, Let Us Rock Them second, third Our Sky Major.
No fears for the immediate future of Grand Circuit racing down under.
All the big guns are right up there heading off the back straight, but it's Ideal Scott at the 400 in front.
Rising Stars right down to the wire.
They're flying around the turn. They're going really fast now. Ideal Scott in front from Besotted, who's coming. Ideal Scott has to be shaken up. Besotted right there coming through Kiang Steamer. What's he got left? Ideal Scott. He's just the leader from Kiang Steamer and Besotted. Ideal Scott clings on and wins. Ideal Scott beat Besotted. I reckon Besotted's run was nearly the run of the season in defeat.
For diehard fans of the Certainties in Racing Do Exist theory, the unbeatable Kiwi Colt.
Bit of a Legend goes into overdrive now, and he pulled away. And Bit of a Legend around the turn is out by 15 on Pasha Cutie. But Bit of a Legend, it's a walk in the park. Bit of a Legend wins by 10, he's down.
To finish, on the face of it, probably the race fans penciled in for a lunch break or light refreshments. Well, hold on to your champagne strawberries for the start of the Breeders' Crown four-year-old trot final.
Now out wide, Rosalie Bay galloped or tipped out Shakemon's driver. Rebecca Bartley was badly interfered with by Rosalie Bay, and they were two of the horses in the market are out of play here. Rebecca Bartley's, she's conscious, but she's right in the middle of the track, 50 metres from the line. That driverless horse is going through the field, so we've got all sorts of issues here. We've got safety concerns. This horse is out of control.
We're up all night to get lucky. We're up all night to get lucky. We're up all night to get lucky.
And Shakemon's about to end up on the lake, I reckon. And it's come to a stop and got to its feet with the clerk of the course in hot pursuit. So
not quite ridiculousness, but close. The cause of all this calamity?
Way across Rosalie Bay, who galloped the first time and then gets out quick. So that's just the luck of the draw, isn't it?
Cashes.
Rosalie Bay's had a brilliant run third on the pegs.
The check.
It's Rosalie Bay, Maori's favourite son, and Rosalie Bay got through to win it.
In take two.